Welcome back to the SOTI how-to video series. Did you know that with SOTI MobiControl, you can simplify the task of Android device management and configurations through automation? To be able to add devices automatically, you need to make sure your MobiControl instance is set up to make it so. Hello, my name is MJ, and I'm a principal instructor here at SOTI. In this episode, I will show you how to set up add device rules, which enables you to configure the settings that your SOTI MobiControl uses to set up and communicate with your Android devices. Let's jump in. In the MobiControl console, click on the menu icon and then, from the drop-down menu, select Rules. Next, go to the Android Plus tab and in the column on the left-hand side, right-click Add Devices and select Create Add Devices Rule. This will launch the Create Add Devices Rule setup wizard. Enter the desired name for the Add Devices Rule. Next, choose the option to use when selecting the destination device group for devices enrolling using this Add Devices Rule. Two methods are available. Manual. This will allow you to manually select the device group where the enrolled devices will be placed. Or, based on user group membership. The device will be placed into groups based on the membership of the user account assigned to the device. You will be able to associate user groups to specific device groups later in the wizard. In this video, we will stick with the manual method and click Next. Here, select the device group from the list to enroll your devices. Next, select how to authenticate the devices during enrollment. The first method is to leverage your directory service like Azure AD or an identity provider like SOTI Identity. This will ensure that only the people from your organization can enroll. The second method is to enter a password during device enrollment. Create the password here. Finally, you can choose not to have any verification and anyone with an enrollment ID will be allowed to enroll their device into MobiControl, which is the method we will choose for this video. As well, at the bottom of this menu, you can confirm the certificate authentication authority. Since we are using SOTI MobiControl, this will be populated by default. Next, you can choose to enable the Terms and Conditions setting and select the Terms and Conditions document from the drop-down list. If you haven't uploaded the Terms and Conditions document, then click Manage to add a new document. In this case, we will not be using the Terms and Conditions and will move on to the next step, which is to choose the permissions to be granted during enrollment. Most Android applications require users to grant permissions during installation. For the MobiControl agent, we can automatically allow these settings to be enabled without user intervention since they are corporately owned. We can enable permissions to draw over other applications. This grants permission to display content on top of other apps in the foreground. For example, this is used in kiosk mode for configurations like single app mode and similar. Modify system settings. This allows system settings to be modified, like the network settings or any of the device feature controls. Notifications access. This grants the permission to read all notifications posted by the system or any installed app. And usage access, which allows access to app usage history and collects detailed information. We will keep all of them checked and click Next. Now we will move on to choosing an Android Enterprise setup option. If you are using Manage Google Play accounts or Manage Google accounts to deploy and manage apps and to provide a curated Google Play Store for your organization, here is where you can include that in your enrollment rule. We can choose between Manage Google Play accounts. Select this option to manage the devices using a Manage Google Play account. Select the enterprise you want to use from the list. This is the approach that we recommend using if your desired enrollment is Android Enterprise focused. Manage Google accounts. Select this option to manage devices using Google accounts created in the Google Admin Console. For the first two options, you'll have to create an AE binding. Please watch our How to Create an AE Binding video for detailed steps on how to do this. Next is Skip Google Account Addition during enrollment on Managed Android Devices. Select this option if your devices will not require access to the Managed Google Play Store. enroll your fully managed device with a work profile. Select this option if you want to enroll your device as corporate personal, also known as work managed device, with a profile for the device user's data and apps. This time we will choose to skip add the Google account and click next to move on with the setup. Now we need to choose the download source for the Android Plus device agent. For Android Enterprise enrollment, select download from the Google Play Store to ensure the devices are always updated with the latest device agent, or in the case of Android Classic, or if the device does not have access to the Google Play Store, select to download directly from the server. In this case, we will use the Google Play Store to download the agent. Below, you can see the Android Enterprise device agent is selected by default. Next, we need to specify a naming convention for the devices. You can choose a combination of text and/or macros to follow any naming convention in your organization. Additionally, clicking on the settings icon will allow you to choose from several suggested macro options for the device names. In our example, every device enrolled will be labeled as Android Plus with a 5-digit number added incrementally. Some manufacturers and devices need a plugin to have additional functionality available specifically for MobiControl. So if this is the case, here you can enable and manage plugins. In our case, we will stick with the default and click Next. Finally, we can review the enrollment settings and click on the Advanced button to configure any advanced options for this rule. Since we are happy with our current setup, we will click Finish to save the new Add Devices rule. After that is done, the enrollment ID and the enrollment URL will be presented so they can be easily shared with the users. And that's it. The Add Devices rule has been successfully created and you're ready to deploy devices. In just a few minutes, I've shown you how to set up an Add Devices rule, which enables you to configure the settings that SOTI MobiControl uses to set up and communicate with your Android devices. Thank you for tuning in. And if you find our content valuable, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates. To learn more about how the SOTI One platform reduces the cost, complexity, and downtime of your business-critical mobile and IT operations, visit soti.net.